Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who creates, redeems, and sustains us and all of creation. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Faithful God, have mercy on us. We confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We turn from your loving embrace and go our own ways. We cast judgment on one another before examining ourselves. We place our own needs before those of our neighbors. We keep your gift of salvation to ourselves. Make us humble, cast away our transgressions, and turn us again to life in you through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. God is the cause of all who fall out of need, and through his death and resurrection, Christ has made us his own. Hear the truth that God proclaims. Your sins are forgiven in the name of Jesus Christ. Let God the Holy Spirit live in freedom and newness to do God's work in the world. You may be seated. Let us remember all the faith before God. We praise and bless you, O Holy Trinity. You have taught your church that it is an ageless communion of saints. We thank you for gathering those who faithfully waited in hope for the redemption you promised. And now, for joining us to celebrate the love of Christ for the redemption of the world. We thank you for the faithful lives of our Lord Jesus Christ. Grace Simmons. Diane Herman. Joyce Schumacher. Irene Thomas. Anthony Gasparo. Peter Schilling III. Elizabeth Mohawker. Harry Mohawker. Thomas Mohawker. Dave Patrick. Michael Maresca. Helen Murphy. John Murphy. Kathleen Tillman. Arthur Tillman. Mary Murphy. Francis Maresca. Cornelius Maresca. Frank Linkletter, Carol Linkletter, Mary Menani, Patrick Dunn, Neil Rosen, Andrea Rosen, Virginia Bennett, James Bennett, Charles J. Schroeder, Jr. Desiree Kalani. And those we name now, silently or aloud. Prepare a place for us among those who are already with you. Help us remember them as an encouragement to saintly living, exciting us to life in anticipation of an eternal union with them we praise and bless you, O Holy Trinity. Jesus says, I take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. for my work is easy and my burden is light. Be kindness for your sake. After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship Him day and night within His temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. to the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the waters of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Psalm is Psalm 34. I will bless the Lord at all times. The praise of God shall be ever in my mouth.
Lord, let the lowly hear and rejoice.
Proclaim with me the greatness of the Lord. Let us exalt God's name together.
I sought the Lord, who answered me, and delivered me of all my terrors.
Look upon the Lord, and be radiant, and let not your faces be ashamed. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear the Lord, and delivers them.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed are they who take refuge in Him.
Fear the Lord, you saints of the Lord, for those who fear the Lord lack nothing.
The lions are in want and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack nothing that is good.
O Lord, you redeem the life of your servants, and those who put their trust in you will not be punished.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up to the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him, and he began to speak, and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you, and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Be praised and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you, the gospel of the Lord."
Surprise!
What? It's a surprise.
I'm not
sure that. Most of us can still be excited, and we hear this simple word, surprise. It signals something unexpected is about to happen. We may squeal or cry with an overflow of emotion. Now, surely, like this, a couple to plan something for me. I'm not a huge fan of surprise parties. So much extra planning, intricate secrecy, working on lines, and
to be trapped or fall over. It can be stressful and exhausting. And so we all have stories of fun and wonderful surprises that we have experienced in our lives. Time for me to fill with joy and excitement with something unexpected. And we know you, the community of a phone call from an old friend, maybe a card or flowers for no reason, other than someone who is thinking about us. But all surprises are not so much fun. Sometimes a surprise catches us off guard. It changes the way we think about something. Becomes more of a, gee, I never thought about it that way. Or a moment. The surprise is that maybe we had been wrong about what we were thinking. Today's gospel has that kind of a surprise for the disciples. Already, it comes at the beginning of Jesus' ministry. He had just gathered his disciples and began teaching them in the crowds that were beginning to follow them. In the famous Sermon on the Mount, Jesus begins a lengthy discussion that we find one of Jesus' most important teachings. When he saw the crowd, he went up to the mountaintop, normally a place to shower, a place to stand over others, and to deliver profound announcements or really important news. Standing above everyone would illustrate how powerful and important the speaker was. It was a place to honor and respect. But instead of towering over those he was teaching, Jesus sat down with them and began speaking to them. Surprise, I'm not your everyday teacher, Jesus seemed to be saying. I'm here to teach you how to rule over others, how to take control of nations by warfare and violence. I'm not the king you probably expected. I will teach you to love and care for one another, to love kindly and welcome the strangers. Surprise! The teaching of that day are known as the Beatitudes, the Blessed Are. Blessed are the poor in spirit, the meek, those who mourn, the merciful are the peacemakers, the pure in heart, those who are persecuted for the Lord's sake. One by one, Jesus names the human condition and calls those blessed who are experiencing it. One by one, Jesus turns a human condition into a heavenly one. He proclaims us as children of God, inhabitants of the earth, members of the kingdom of heaven. We're comforted, filled, and strong mercy. Jesus uses positive reinforcement. Instead of recommending those who cannot empathize with the pain of others to show them mercy, he promises rewards beyond all imagination for those who are so blessed with that compassion. Jesus recognizes some of the most profound human conditions, hunger and thirst for justice, mourning the loss of a loved one, weakness in the face of oppression, and promises that God has not forgotten those who engage in everyday common struggles. They are in God's loving care. Jesus recognizes those who look out for others, those who are good neighbors. He lifts up those with an ordinary mind of mercy and compassion. He lifts up the ordinary saints in the crowd. Jesus promises them that they are God's children. They will receive reward beyond measure in this life and in the next. Today we celebrate All Saints Sunday, the great year we honor the saints of saints that are no longer with us on our earthly journey. Our loved ones, friends, neighbors, even our enemies, who are now resting in God's heavenly kingdom for their labors in this lifetime. We look at the candles glowing on the baptismal font, the signs that we're all claimed as children of God at our baptism, and welcome into God's family from that day onward. We look at the extra candle, reminding us of Christ's life-giving sacrifice on the cross, a gift of forgiveness and salvation, a promise of everlasting Christ. A few minutes ago, we named those beloved saints who have gone on to their eternal rest. Saints who have turned their lives with obedience and mansions to put them to work in school and came to church. Folks who have demanded thoughts of the time and prayed for forgiveness when they couldn't. There are people who are associated with fellow saints and sinners. But most importantly, there were people who were called blessed by Jesus. And there were people who have been weak and blessed in health and love in our lifetimes. Jesus supplies those who have done that day. They have now had an experience like none other. They saw a new type of leader emerge on the mountain. When it was with kindness and mercy and love, when it mixed with words and bread and fish, instead of swords and power and conditions of cross. They were the man who teach them how to love their God and how to love one another. They learned that they were truly blessed to be children of God, just as they were. The second reading today is when the saints go marching in, a song traditionally associated with New Orleans and funeral marches, that reassures us that our loved ones are blessed saints, and we're sending them off to the heavenly kingdom with joy and thanksgiving for their lives on earth. On this day of Saints Day 2020, in a year that has held plenty of fabulous, mighty signs of joy, may we be blessed to know how truly blessed we are. And may the many wonders and surprises that our Lord Jesus has in store for us continue to astonish and amaze us each and every day. Amen.
the friends who are gathered today to the all those who have been called by God's Spirit to inquire into the Christian faith in this congregation. Together, let us welcome them to this journey of faith in Jesus Christ. The following young people desire to be involved in the confirmation program at St. Peter's Lutheran Church. I ask them to step out of the aisle right next to a few who will be a parent for sponsors. Joseph Fernando, Zachary Sohn, A.J. DiCarlo, Tom Berger, John Martinitis, Kyle Sohn, and Daniel Lyon. And your responses are in those. What do you ask of God's church? What do you seek from God's word? Students, grace and mercy are given to all who call upon God's name. Now I invite you to join with this assembly to hear the word of God. Will you be faithful in learning the way of God? Sponsors, will you join the assembly to hear the word of God? Will you be faithful in your support of these students as they learn the way of Christ? All of you assembled here are called to welcome and support these candidates and their sponsors. Will you help them hear the gospel of Christ and come into the household of faith? Let us pray. Let us give thanks to these servants whom you have sought and summoned in many ways. You have called them today, and they have answered you in your presence. We praise you, O God, and we bless you. You will hear the holy and saving gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now receive the sign of the gospel on your body and in your heart, that you may know the Lord and the power of his resurrection. I invite your sponsors to make crosses on your body as you go through this with me. Receive the cross on your forehead, a sign of endless love and mercy for you. Learn to know and follow Christ. Christ, the wisdom and power of God. Receive the cross on your ears, that you may hear the gospel of Christ, the word of life. O Christ, the wisdom and power of God. Receive the cross on your eyes, that you may see the light of Christ, illumination to your way. Receive the cross on your lips, that you may sing the praise of Christ, the joy of the church. Receive the cross on your heart, that God may dwell there by faith. Receive the cross on your shoulders, that you may bear the gentle yoke of Christ. Receive the cross on your hands, that God's mercy may be known in your will. Receive the cross on your feet, that you may walk in the way of Christ. Let us pray. Blessed and most high God, creator and life giver of all that is, you have called all people from darkness into light, from error into truth, from death into life. We ask that you grant grace to Joseph, Zachary, AJ, Sean, Kyle, Daniel, and bless them. Raise them by your Spirit, revive them by your word, form them by your hand, bring them to the water of life and to the bread and cup of blessing, that with all your people they may be a witness to your grace and praise you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We welcome them into our confirmation program. And may be seated in our prayer.
with his people and to appear as a God, the response is your mercy is great. Longing for Christ's home to come among us, we pray for the outpouring of God's power on the church, the world, and all in need. Lord of all saints, we praise you for evangelists and martyrs whose sacrifices witness to your gospel across time and space. Inspire us by their courage to carry out our new faith to new people and places around us. Hear us, O God, and let your grace. Lord of every place, the universe proclaims your greatness from generation to generation. Bless the work of naturalists, conservationists, park rangers who train our attention to the wonders of the world you have made. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Lord of every nation, guide this country, red states and blue states, rural voters and urban voters, young and old, as we share in another national election. Kindle hearts eager to understand our common needs and seek our common good. Hear us, O God.
Mercy is good.
Lord of every blessing, your Son's blessing came to those living with poverty, grief, hunger, thirst, and persecution. Shape our vision of the saints to match his own. Awaken in us your call to serve all who suffer, especially our sick. Stephen, Bruce, Aaron, John, Christina, Bob, Steve, Teresa, Elsa, Evelyn, Kate, Philip, George, Mary, Charlie, Jackie, Phoebe, Jimmy, Evelyn, Eleanor, Kim, John, Mary, Alexander, Anna, Cusack, Wally, Karen, William, Marianne, and Kathy. Hear us, O God.
Mercy is great.
Lord of every venture, anoint us with the missionary spirit of the early church. Bless all new missions of our synod. Empower testimony from new communities of faith which is shaped with the first witness to your saving power. Hear us, O God.
Mercy is great.
Lord of every time, countless are the multitudes you have called by name and gathered to yourself. Comfort us as we grieve those who have died in the past. In faith, may we join with them in ceaseless praise. Hear us, O God.
Mercy is great.
Receive our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Until that day when you gather all creation around your throne, where you will reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's share that. This week is gallantry has more to do with a person's thoughts and values than what is in their bank account. Please rise as your image.
Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. You have set before us these gifts of your creation. Prepare us for your heavenly banquet. Nourish us with this year's food and drink, and send us forth to set tables in the midst of a suffering world. Through the bread of life, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Yes, could you please take it out the bread that you brought with you for communion, or share free to come up and get a waiter. Holy, mighty, and merciful Lord, heaven are full of your glory. In great love, you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after his supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink. "Bring this cup with the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you in the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory now and forever. Gathered into one, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come to the banquet table where Christ gives himself as food and drink. We give you thanks, gracious God, that you have once again fed us with food beyond compare, the body and blood of our life. Lead us from this place, nourished and forgiven, into your beloved vineyard, to wipe away the tears of all who hunger and thirst. Guided by the example of the same Jesus Christ, and led by the Holy Spirit now and forever. May you see this announcement. This month, we again have opportunities to help feed the hungry. Thank you for everyone who has so generously brought
Thank you.
What is our mission?
Sharing God's love and serving community.
Go in peace, remember the poor. Thank you.